The address is 36 Balham. That's B-A-L-H-A-M. Gardens, London, SW. Dated the 21st of August, 1917. Now, begin. Dearest, I have wonderful news. No. You write the letter. Imagine that you've just had a baby and that you are writing to the father.
Don't think of me. Think of someone you love.
I can't.
You can. I know that you can. You haven't seen him for many months. You may never see him again. He might never see his child. Now imagine that. And, well, write what you feel.
How I wish you were here now. I am longing for you, as I have ever since you left me. And I would love to show you our little baby son. He is so good. You mustn't worry about either of us. I'm getting stronger every day, and doctor says that baby couldn't be better.
I would have sent you a telegram.
Of course. You did. And I, that is he, would have replied. It would have taken about 3 days.
If it had been you arriving here instead of the telegram, how lovely that would have been. I look forward so very much to the day when we can hold our little son and be together for the rest of our lives, in peace. Goodbye, my darling. Nurse says I mustn't tire myself by writing too much, but I will write a longer letter very soon. Take care of yourself, and please, please come back to us. Your loving wife, Anne. Baby sends a kiss to Daddy.
Charming. Everything I could have wanted. Thank you. Anybody home?
I wasn't told you were coming.
No, you weren't. One of those hush-hush jobs. You know, real boys' own paper stuff. Sort of thing that makes Lighthorsemen think that Pommy intelligence officers are a bunch of schoolboys playing wizard japes on the enemy.
But this one's different.
Very. It could open the way to Jerusalem.
Well, what can I do?
I need an escort for a sortie out towards Beersheba.
Well, I'd be delighted.
Well, no, it's not quite as simple as that. No, I need an enlisted man, a good man, a man that knows the country and can look after himself. And me, come to that. But above all, a man who thinks Pommy officers are a bunch of idiots and can be relied on to gossip.
I think we can manage that.
We're getting into enemy territory, sir. Yes. I thought we would be. You see, I do have to get as far east as I can.
Can I ask why, sir?
Of course. You see, old boy, migratory birds are a hobby of mine. And we don't know very much about the migration habits of the stork in Palestine. You know, we see them fly north in the spring, but we don't see them fly south in the autumn. Now, my theory is that their southerly route is further to the east.
We're riding out here to see storks flying south.
Hopefully.
Look, Major, it's a bloody miracle we haven't run into a Turkish patrol, and we better turn back, sir.
This really is hostile territory, then.
Oh, you can take my word for it.
I'll just rest my horse here for a moment, and then we'll turn back. Hmm? Care for a sandwich?
No, thanks, sir. I'll just sit up here, keep an eye open, you know. Major, mount up! Turks!
What? Didn't get us out!
Major!
Coming, Corporal, coming.
Papers make it clear. Two brigades will make a limited attack on us here in Beersheba to divert attention from a major offensive against Gaza. But this could be a trick. Planted information.
That is possible, Colonel Ismet. But this letter from the officer's wife, speaking of their new baby, it's from the heart. Not something to deliberately part with. Now, General von Kressenstein has made me responsible for all intelligence operations in this sector. And I stake my military career on it, Colonel. The loss of that letter was accidental. Therefore, the information is genuine.
We will assume that any attack on Beersheba is a mere decoy. But I shall plant explosives in all the wells, ammunition dumps, and railway installations. If they capture Beersheba, they will win a broken, burning ruin. Their army will be stranded here without water. If this is a trick, they have set a gigantic trap for themselves.